premier passage sur le tapis rouge avec les acteurs qui incarnent les vieux de temps et plus, les troncs marmolés. Il y a Giuliano Mantovani, Gian Piero Capello, Melchiore Palla.
So here
Romana
we have the director. On the red carpet is a kind of false red carpet because she's supposed to wait for the official music on all of the animals. But there she wanted to have her photo taken with all of the young actors from the film, those who don't play lead roles. These are the supporting, this is the supporting cast, you might say. So, and Alice Rovacher wanted to have her photo taken with two teams, with the supporting actors and also with the main actors. So that's what's going to happen this afternoon. We'll hear the official music a little later on. So this film talks about pillaging tombs, archaeology, Etruscan culture. Now, what does that bring to mind? Other films about archaeology. What about Call Me By Your Name? Starring Timothy Chalamet, because Chalamet's father in the film is a university lecturer and he invites a student to the summer house, and that's where this guest student meets Timothy. And it also makes us think of Indiana Jones. As soon as you're talking about tombs and archaeology, you think of Indiana Jones, who we also had here in Cannes this year. What about Sir Percy Fawcett, who disappeared when he was hunting for hidden treasures? It's great to see Isabella Rossellini here on the red carpet. She stars in the film, directed by Alice Rohrwacher. What can we say about Isabella? Blue Velvet, for example. Sailor and Lula. A golden palm for Sailor Lula. Why is she called Rossellini? Well, Rossellini is her dad and Ingrid Bergman was her mum. So Isabella Rossellini acted in Two Lovers by James Gray, which is in competition in 2008, and Death Becomes You by Zemeckis. Yes, Isabella Rossellini enjoys going out of her comfort zone. So she's also worked for Guimardin, Ferrara, the Taviani brothers. Quite a track record she's got. It's very moving to see this young film director back in Cannes with these young actors and actresses. People say that Italian movies aren't faring too well at the moment. They're supposed to be ailing. They're the sick branch of the family in Europe. Their figures are terrible. The box offices are down in Italy. People don't seem to be going to the movies anymore in Italy. Yet there are plenty of films being produced, so that doesn't seem to be balanced out very well. But here we've had Alice Rohrwacher, we've had Nanni Moretti, who's been here with his film. We've also got Marco Bellocchio in competition. There are three Italian directors in competition at the 76th Cannes Film Festival. So the production side is there. I think the concern is more about people not going to the movies anymore. But here we have a whole crop of young actors and actresses. The main actor is Josh O'Connor. On your screen now you can see Vincenzo Nemolato. These are actors and actresses from the film The Chimera, a film directed by Alice Rohrwacher, who is Italian despite her German-sounding name. Josh O'Connor was in Florence Foster Jenkins by Stephen Frears, if I'm not mistaken. I think there was with Meryl Streep also. It's a story about a singer who wants to become very famous despite her rather poor voice. So here we are on the red carpet for The Chimera.
Présenté en compétition
Cannes. Avec nous, sur le tapis rouge, la réalisatrice Alice Rohrwacker, ses interprètes, Josh O'Connor, comédien britannique, la brésilienne Carol Duarte.
Just listening to the voice on the red carpet there saying Alice Rohrwacker and not Alice Rohrwacker. So there are many variations that are allowed. Alice or Alice Rohrwacker or Rohrwacher. So the film by the director is in competition. It stars the sister of the director, Alice's sister, Alba, and it stars also Isabella Rossellini, a living legend of the movie world, daughter of Ingrid Bergman. Here we have a fine crew of Italian actors and actresses. So this film by Alice Rohrwacher is the third chapter in a trilogy, and it focuses on tomb raiders who go to pillage Etruscan tombs. There we have in the center of the screen there the lead role, Josh O'Connor. He goes to pillage the tombs in search of his own personal chimera. In life, everybody has their own chimera, something they try to achieve but never manage to find. In fact, this film has several layers. You've got the chimera of archaeology. You've got the chimera of the mythical animal or creature. And so this is a strong contender for the Golden Palm. Alice Rohrwacher has already won two prizes, one for Best Direction and one Grand Prix. The Grand Prix was for The Wonders in 2014. And Happy as Lazaro was Best Screenplay in Cannes 2018. And here she is back in competition. Perhaps she's going to be one rung higher on this ladder to the stars. Perhaps she'll get the Golden Palm this time. This is the 20th film in the competition. There are 21 in all, and we've got the Ken Loach to follow. So this is the 20th film in competition. We'll be talking about Ken Loach in just a short while. But for the time being, we're talking about The Chimera by Alice Rohrwacher, starring her sister, or featuring at least her sister, Alba Rohrwacher, and Isabella Rossellini and Josh O'Connor. The two sisters, the two Rohrwacher sisters, wanted to join the circus when they were little. One wanted to be an acrobat, one wanted to be a clown. And Alice Rohrwacher has said that it was thanks to the circus that she wanted to get involved in the entertainment industry. She wanted to make films. Here we have the new wave of Italian film. Alice Rohrwacher is the spearhead, and she's also to be seen in the Nanni Moretti film, which is also in competition. And Nanni Moretti refers to the new wave of Italian movies and movie makers. And this film talks about a thriving market in Italy, one of stolen archaeological artifacts. People who go and raid Etruscan tombs and sell the artifacts which they steal. Alice Rohrwacher says that film is all about waste. And I like waste, says Alice Rohrwacher. Well, it's quite a political film, really, because it broaches the role of farmers. She mentions Pasolini and says that Fellini would describe the countryside, though criticizing those who would say how wonderful and beautiful the countryside is without taking care of the countryside. Alice Rohrwacher hopes to restore the countryside thanks to the films that she makes. So she really is the figurehead of the latest wave of Italian filmmakers, a new wave of Italian film. Alice Rohrwacher started out her career editing documentaries. In fact, her first film, the first film which she directed herself, was also a documentary. So her film talks about lost loves, and that's the subtext of the story. Josh O'Connor plays the role of a British guy who's come back to Italy in search of a lost love. He was also seen in Mothering Sunday. Isabelle Rossellini is there. She's been in Golden Palm winning films before, but she's not afraid to go and venture into new territories to be experimental. Alba and her sister Alice Rohrwacher. Alba has worked with the Diplashan brothers, for Nanni Moretti. She was in Tre Piani. She was in Ismael's Ghost. And now they're entering into the festival hall. I really do think this film is in with a good chance of coming home with a prize. Perhaps not the Golden Palm, but perhaps the Grand Prix. We'll be back at 5:45 for the red carpet of the final film in competition. It's called The Old Oak and it's by Ken Loach. See you later. Thank you.